I put a propeller on a 1 horsepower motor just to try it out and blow some leaves with it. And more than half the comments I get is that I should put a cowling around the propeller to make it more efficient. Because as that propeller spins round and round, it pushes the air this way, but centrifugal force will push it this way, so the air is going to go all around like this. But checking this with a regular oscillating fan, of course it blows out straight in front, but just coming off the side a little bit, it seems to actually suck instead of blow. And of course it sucks in the back, and even on the sides it seems to suck in. So let's check the same thing with my 1 horsepower fan. So I was just reviewing that clip, and right next to the fan blade, it sucks air in. And then in front of the fan blade, the airstream is about as wide as the fan blade. But when we get a bit further away, it actually narrows a little bit. That's an interesting sort of thing. Let's probe in front of it a little bit more. So here is what I think is happening. The fan blade is moving a lot of air closer to the edges of the blade because that's what's moving the fastest. So that air is getting thrown forward. Not so much air coming from the middle because it's moving too slow and I don't even have blades in the very middle. So as this air moves forward, it mixes with the air in the middle and throws that forward as well. So if there's a lot of air coming this way, but there isn't as much being blown in this way, which means we have a bit of a vacuum right here, and that vacuum is actually causing this air to get sucked towards the middle because there's a vacuum. More air is coming in from the side to make up for some of this, which is why you're seeing the airflow kind of going towards the stream right about here. And the stream, actually, the intense part of the stream doesn't widen out right away. Instead, we've got more air being mixed in with that stream, turbulent mixing, pulling in air this way, and that's what widens the stream. But the actual jet coming off of the propeller actually is fairly narrow. So if we had a cowling around this fan, well, it would prevent the fan blades from sucking in air from the sides, which is ironic. And for the fan, the stream already kind of converges a little bit just because of the vacuum in the middle of it. So the cowling wouldn't really do very much. I suppose we could make it funnel-shaped to follow the stream as it's going already, and that would prevent it from mixing in more air from the side, which would cause the middle of the stream to continue to move faster, but it would actually cause it to move less air overall than it currently is moving. I know people are going to argue with me about the vacuum in front of the fan idea, so I thought, let's see if I can actually detect it. So this pipe ends at a right angle straight in front of the fan, and let's see if there's air going through it. Okay, pipe is shaking a little bit. There's the end. Yes, it sucks. Now, people are going to argue Bernoulli principle and all that, which actually doesn't really apply to turbulent airflow. Let's move it back a little bit, see if I can still see any vacuum. So now, the airspeed is probably about maximum right about here. Let's see if I'm gonna get some vacuum.
Okay, let's see what happens.
Oh. That's a bit surprising to see vacuum this far out, but I guess we do have air kind of coming in from the side and the stream is already kind of narrowing here a little bit. Let's move this a bit further out, say right about here, and we should see a lot less vacuum by now.
Still vacuum!
Now aiming the pipe actually into the stream a little bit, we should be getting air coming out of it. So even pointing into the airstream, it's still sucking a little bit. Amazing.
now with the pipe pointing further into the airstream, now, finally, it flows just a little wee bit.
Well, I find that completely fascinating. So putting a cowling around the airstream would cause less air to get in there. You would think the pressure in the cowling would be greater, it would be pushing the air together. But no, it would actually prevent the air from pulling in more air. I was able to get a nice smooth trail of sawdust if I dumped out the sawdust straight in front of the fan. But if I introduced it from the top or from behind the fan, it always seemed to diverge a bit. And I realized afterwards, that's because the airstream is spinning, and especially if I run it through the prop, that sawdust just gets thrown out centrifugally. So just like in a cyclone, the sawdust being heavier than the air kind of gets thrown out, although then it kind of gets sucked back in once it's not spinning anymore. And I realized afterwards the reason I was picking up vacuum so far ahead of the propeller is because my airstream was still spinning and actually held together by vacuum. And another interesting thing is my airstream always seemed to be dropping a little bit. I thought I had the motor aimed down, so I shimmed up the front of the box, but it still drops.
So this is the height of the motor, and it flows here, but if I drop that down a bit further, you can see it flows more intensely towards the floor. Not so much air, tons of air.
Man, I wish I'd kept that camera running 1 second longer. There's half of the prop. Here's the other part. I got spared. At first I thought it was because the motor fell off the box and then the prop hit the ground, but there's no obvious sign of the corners of the prop hitting the ground. But then I checked my time-lapse camera and the motor fell face down while it was spinning down, and that killed the prop. And here's the reason the airstream drops down. Because remember, it sucks in air from the sides, but there's the floor in the way here, which means there's no air to suck, which means we get a little bit of vacuum developing here, and that just pulls the airstream down until it hits the floor. So this was supposed to be just a little follow-up video, but it's turned out to be so darn interesting, I think I'll put it on my main channel.